Greetings, and welcome to Covenant Community Church, where people live and discover their God-given purpose. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. We're so excited that you are joining us today for our worship service on this day in January. Now we invite you to share with us in a moment of prayer. Let us pray. Dear God, you are truly our rock, our fortress, our deliverer, and our God and our strength in whom we trust. You are our buckler and horn of salvation. We praise you, O Lord, as we worship you, our Lord and King and Savior. Let the fruits of our lips give you praise continually, and let the lifting of our hands unto you never cease. We pray, O God, that our prayers before you be as incense, and the lifting of our hands be unto you as the evening sacrifice. We pray, dear God, that as we step into this new year, that you will continually bless and allow us to magnify and lift up your holy and mighty and majestic names all the days of our lives, for your loving kindness better than life. And dear God, we pray that we will always love you with our heart, our soul, our strength, and our might, that we may dwell in your presence all the days of our lives, and that we may never lose our love for you, and that we will always seek you first and foremost all the days of our lives. For dear God, when we are thirsty, you are the living water which fills us until we overflow with goodness. When we are hungry, you are the bread of life which feeds our soul. When we are in need of a friend, you are a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And when we need a doctor, oh God, you are our great physician. When we need peace, you are the Prince of Peace. When we are in battle, you are our captain in charge. And when the storms arise, you are our peace in the midst of every storm. And you become our bridge over troubled water. So, dear God, we praise you. We thank you for this day. And, dear God, we pray that we will be ever so mindful of your grace and your mercy. And we pray for the homeless, the sick, and the shut in. We pray for the new leadership of this nation. We pray, dear God, for those who are sick and dying and hurting. And then, God, teach us to pray as you taught the disciples to pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. And the people of God said, amen. Today, beloved, we are excited and privileged to have a guest preacher, not a stranger, to share with us the word of God this morning. And that is in the person of my friend and colleague, the Reverend Rodney T. Francis. Let me just say a little about him as a way of introduction and presentation to some. Reverend Rodney T. Francis serves as the Chief Program Officer at Employ Indy, and he came to Indianapolis from St. Louis in 2016, where he served 8 years as Executive Director of the Youth and Family Center, a 125-year-old neighborhood settlement house. And during the 2014 Ferguson protest, Rodney's youth development work was with the 16 and 24-year-old population. And that work proved instrumental in helping the community chart a path forward towards one of healing, wholeness, and equity. An ordained clergy in the Baptist tradition, Rodney has served as senior pastors to churches in New Jersey and St. Louis, Missouri, where he served at the historic Washington Street Baptist Church in St. Louis. By academic training, Rodney holds a master's degree from Princeton Theological Seminary in Princeton, New Jersey, and a Bachelor of Arts degree from the College of New Rochelle in New York City. He is also a 2009 graduate of The Ohio State University Executive Leadership and Management Program and a 2012 graduate of Focus Leadership St. Louis and a 2014 graduate of the Olin School of Business Not-for-Profit Executive Management Program in Washington University in St. Louis. But more importantly, also is Reverend Rodney is married to the lovely Dr. Leah Gunning Francis, who's the Vice President and Academic Dean at Christian Theological Seminary, bringing new and creative and innovative leadership to the seminary. They're the proud parents of two sons they are raising here in the city, Evan and Desmond. Rodney is a man who looks towards heaven, but his feet are flatly planted on the ground, understanding the complexities of life and the challenges and realities of those whose life may be marginalized by the vicissitudes of life and the challenges. And he certainly can address those issues and work for the least of these. He's a man of God, of faith and integrity. And so we're so glad again to have him back at Covenant. Before he comes, Sister Becky Grider will come to bless us in the ministry of music. And after her, the Reverend Rodney T. Francis will bring the word of life for us this morning. Amen.
Sorrows. I've had questions for tomorrow. There have been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave me blessed consolation that my trials come to only make me strong. Seen a lot of faces. There have been times I felt so all alone. But in my loneliest hours, yes, those precious lonely hours, Jesus let me know that I was. Storms he's brought me through. For if I'd never had a problem, I wouldn't know that God could solve them. I'd never know what faith in God can. Trust in God.
morning. Welcome to the worship experience of the Covenant Community Church. I'm so excited to be here with you this morning to share a word of God on behalf of God. I'm thankful to my friend and brother, Pastor Wallace McLaughlin, for his gracious invitation. And it's always wonderful to be in fellowship with Covenant Community once again. Let us pray. God of mercy, God of grace, God of truth, God of love, God of justice. We thank you today, O God, for this opportunity to be in worship one more time, this opportunity to fellowship with each other, this opportunity to gather virtually or wherever we may be, to say that we are a part of the community. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your love. Thank you, O God, for being the God who is beyond our faults and saw our needs and gave us another chance. Now, as we prepare to hear from you, O Lord, please bring our hearts and our minds, our attentions into your presence this very moment. Allow us to tune our hearts to sing your praises, to tune our hearts to meditate on your word. Speak, Lord. Speak to us today. Forgive us of our sins. Forgive us of our transgressions and iniquities. Give each of us clean hands and pure hearts that we may be worthy, O God, to approach your throne and to hear from you. Let the words of my mouth, the meditations of our hearts, may they be acceptable in your sight. You are our strength and our redeemer. Amen. Amen. Well, let me get right to our word and my assignment this morning, and that is to share a word from the Lord with you. Our text is Psalm 37, verses 1 through 5. And I'll be reading from the King James Version, and the Word of God has this to say. Do not fret because of evildoers, nor be envious of the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and feed on God's faithfulness. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. I want to drop my bucket in verses 3 and 4. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land. Feed on his faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. I want to use that text as a medium to engage us in a conversation around the subject, blessings to come in 2021. Blessings to come in 2021. Beloved, as we gather this morning for worship, I am reminded how profoundly blessed we are. We are blessed because, first, God woke us up this morning, started us on our way, and in the vernacular of our ancestors, they would say, he woke us up and the blood was yet running warm in our veins. We were clothed in our right minds, and even in the midst of a raging pandemic that has overcome our land, swept across our land for almost a year, we still have a reasonable portion of health and strength. We are indeed blessed. Secondly, we're blessed because today marks the first Sunday of the Biden-Harris administration and the end of Trump's four-year reign of terror and trauma against the mind, body, soul, and spirit of black and brown people in this country. A reign, might I add, that ended in a failed insurrection attempt to overthrow the government in the name of white supremacy. We are blessed today, I declare to you. We are blessed because that reign has come to an end and a new era has dawned upon us. To God be the glory. And thirdly, we're blessed because today is but the fourth week of a new year. It's hard to believe that, but it's only the fourth week of the new year. And though 2021 started out like less than a new year for me anyway, for me, 2021 began shaping up like an extension of 2020. And the hope and aspirations and the anticipation of what's possible with the coming of a new year did not arrive for me on New Year Day. It did not arrive for me until this very week, as I witnessed Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, the first woman of color, take the oath of office for president and vice president of the United States of America, along with a Jewish American, an African American, and a Latino American who swept into the U.S. Senate. That is when the veil, the haze and the fog that had dampened my spirit began to lift, and the possibilities that come with the dawn of a new year began to sweep over my soul. So we're blessed, beloved. We are blessed that we have this moment that God has given for us. So for me, this is the first Sunday of a new year. For me, this is the first Sunday of 2021 when I can begin to feel like God is moving in our land, that God is doing something new and the possibilities are endless. This is the day for me. The first day of 2021 where I have this sense that there are more blessings to come in 2021. Well, so as I hurry along to the text and get on this exegetical express to get to our text, the question I want to ask is, how is it that we as a people of God, as a people of faith, can be assured that 2021 will bring more blessings to come? What is the prescription? What does the text have to share with us that can give us some assurance that 2021 can bring more blessings to come? Well, I think there are three things, and then I'm going to move out of your way. First, I think the text tells us to trust in God. Secondly, it tells us to do good for God. And thirdly, we are encouraged to delight ourselves in God. And then God will give us the desires of our heart. Let's look at the text. First, verse 3, part A says, trust in God. And beloved, we should know that Psalm 37 is considered a wisdom psalm. It was written to the nation of Israel as an encouragement to them to not fret over evildoers around them who seem to prosper from their wickedness. David admonishes the people of God to not become distracted by evildoers. Don't admire their wickedness or don't mimic their ways because they will soon pass away. Instead, in this psalm, David encourages them to not become weary in well-doing, but rather hang in there and trust God to give them the desires of their heart. And then in verse 25, he begins to testify from his own experience. And David says, listen, I have been young and now I'm old. And in all my days, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor their seed begging bread. Beloved, what a word that is for us today. What a word there is for us as we embark upon the dawn of a new year, as we move into a new era, a new spirit of life and revival. What a word that is for us, that we should not lose heart or despair over the wickedness and evilness and injuries that we see around us today. But rather, we should trust God, that God will take care of us, that God will protect us, that God will provide for us, that God will make a way for us. That if we would but put our trust in God, God will give us the desires of our hearts. Now hear me. To trust in God is to obey God's word. The root of the Hebrew word for trust in this pericope is an active and not passive word. In other words, we demonstrate our trust in God through our obedience to God's word. And it is in our obedience to God's word that we will receive the desires of our hearts and the blessings to come in 2021. You know, do you know that often with God, before the blessing comes a command? Yes, often before God gives the blessing, he gives a command for us to obey. In fact, it is our obedience to the command that unleashes God's blessings on our behalf. Did you know that? Yeah. The Bible reveals with great clarity that the experiencing of God's blessings upon our lives is not determined by luck, is not determined by looks, is not determined by haters, by our education, it's not determined by our title or our social status, it's not determined by the state of the economy, not by who's in the White House, it's not determined by the power of our enemy or the alignment of the stars or the moon being in Jupiter. None of that is the determining factor for the blessing that God has for us as a people of faith. But our blessings from God is contingent upon our willingness to trust God and be obedient to God's word. Listen, for example, in the Gospels, there was a man who was blind from birth. He heard Jesus was coming by because the crowd was calling his name, and the man cried out, "Jesus, Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me." But before he could receive his blessing, Jesus first gave the man a command. He told the man, "Go to the pool of Siloam and wash." The man obeyed. And what was his blessing? The man came back with seeing eyes. What about the man with the withered hand? There it was, swinging at his side, useless to him all his life. He cried out to Jesus for a healing. "Lord Jesus, heal me." Jesus heard him and gave him a command, "Stretch forth thine hand." The blessing, the man's hand was straightened out and went up in praise. There goes Jesus again. This time, 10 lepers were walking in a colony. They heard Jesus was passing by. They cried out to Jesus for a healing. What does he do? He issues them a command. "Go show yourself to the priests." And the Bible says, out of their obedience, they took off towards the temple. And as they went, they were healed. That is the word of God. I'm telling you, beloved, with God, the command often comes before the blessing. We must obey God's word in order to receive God's blessing. Oh, you don't believe me? The command, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness." The blessing, "All these things shall be added unto you." The command, "Come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden." The blessing, "I will give you rest." The command, "Lean not unto your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him." The blessing, "He will direct your path." The command, "Bring up a child in the way that he or she should go." The blessing, "When they are old, they will not depart from it." The command, "Ask." The blessing, "And you shall receive." The command, "Seek." The blessing, "And you shall find." The command, "Knock." The blessing, "And the door shall be opened." The command, "Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, says the Lord." And the blessing, "I will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing you shall not have room enough to receive." I tell you, my brothers and sisters, if you don't walk away with anything else from this message this morning, please receive this word. Before we can receive the blessings from God, we must first obey God's command, and therein lies our blessings to come in 2021. Well, I don't know about you, but that's good news. It's good news to me. It's good news to know that nobody can block my blessings or derail my deliverance but me. Because the songwriter says, what God has for me, it is for me. Our blessings from God are dependent upon our willingness to walk in God's principles and to trust God's command. If we want the blessings, we must first obey God's commands. So the first thing we must do is trust God. And then after we trust God and obey God, we must then, as the text says, do good for God. Look at it. After encouraging the people to trust God in verse 3, part A, David continues in part B of verse 3 and admonishes them to do good in the land. So here's a hermeneutical and exegetical hint. Whenever we see God issuing a decree, a law, an admonishment to do this or stop doing that, it is a good indication that that is there because that's the very thing the people either were doing or were not. So in this text, when David admonishes the people to do good in the land, it is most likely because it's not what they were doing. In fact, the historian suggests that the people had begun to adopt the unjust, oppressive, and exploitive behaviors of the nations around them. They had become just like the pagan nations around them and the nations for whom they were to be a light and an example unto God. David's encouragement to do good in the land is to remind them of who they are, whose they are, and as such, what behavior is expected of them. They are to do good in the land. What exactly is to do good in the land? Here I think the prophets and Jesus can be particularly instructive to us. The prophet Micah says in 6 and 8, what does the Lord require of thee? God has shown you what is good and what the Lord requires of you but to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. The law of hospitality dictates that they are to welcome the stranger and embrace the wanderer. Jesus reminds us in Matthew 25th chapter that we are to look after the least of these. Look after the hungry, the naked, the sick, and the imprisoned. And James says, true and undefiled religion before God is to look after the widows and care for the orphans. So my brothers and sisters, this call to do good in the land is a call for us, the people of God, to engage in this act of disinterested benevolence. Disinterested benevolence are acts of kindness towards the other that does not expect anything in return. They are pure acts of love and seeks no self-interest. They are the acts of kindness that are not centered on us, not centered on our family, us four and no more. It's about helping someone in need. It's about seeing an injustice being done and making a decision to lift our voice in protest and call for justice. It is no longer to turn a blind eye to problems and oppressions and violence, but rather to become a part of the solution to bring an end to the oppression. This imperative is to challenge all of us to be a blessing to someone in 2021. Who can we bless in this coming year? With whom can we share the love of God through some disinterested act of kindness? What group, what organization, what charity, what nonprofit, what cause can we share our time, our talents, and our treasures in 2021? Doing good for God is about being a blessing to come in 2021. And beloved, what I've discovered from my 50 plus years of living, the more you give, the more God gives to you. The more you seek to become a blessing to others, the more God sends blessings your way. God increases blessings to us that they may pass through us to help somebody else. And anything that passes through us can't help but bless us as it passes through. David said to the people, if you want God to bless you with the desires of your heart, then you must seek to do good in the land. And then after doing good in the land, and after trusting God, we must then take delight in God. Verse 4, David says, delight yourself in God, and God will give you the desires of your heart. So we must trust God. We must do good for God. And then we must delight ourselves in God. You know, most often when we hear this verse 4 of Psalm 37, part A is nearly always omitted. We seem to only hear part B, where it says, and he will give you the desires of your heart. But we rarely hear part A connected to B. Yes, it says God will give you the desires of your heart, but the first part of it says, if you first delight yourself in God, then God will give you the desires of your heart. Most of us tend to leap over part A and jump right to part B. Beloved, David is making it explicitly clear to his audience, and consequently you and I, that God is not interested in giving us everything our heart desires. God is interested in satisfying the heart desires of those who delight in God, those who delight in worshiping, serving, and praising God. To take delight in God is to be more interested in pleasing God than impressing men and amassing things. You see, some people are more focused on the blessing than they are the blessor. There are some people who are more concerned with receiving the gift than they are the gift giver. Some people seek after the material more than they want the master. Their heart's desires is to floss and bling rather than please the King of Kings. But God wants to bless those who delight and desire, and God's desire is to please him. Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and God's righteousness, and then all these things shall be added unto you. So as we continue to move into 2021, having put 2020 and all that came with it, the pandemic, Trump, and everybody and everything that came along with Donald Trump, as we move to put those things behind us, to move into this new year, let us do so with this imperative in mind, that if we are to see blessings to come in 2021, we must trust in God. We must seek to do good for God, and we must delight our way in God. Then and only then will the blessings come in 2021. This is the word of God to the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. God, we thank you for reminding us through your word that we should not fret over evildoers, but like the grass that withers away, so shall they pass. But that we should delight ourselves in you, that we should trust in you, that we should do good in the land, and we should delight in pleasing and worshiping you. Help us, O God, as we continue into 2021, to focus our priorities, to focus our activities, to focus our hearts, our minds, to order our steps so that they will align with your word and with your commands, because we desire to receive your blessings. And your blessings will only come as we seek to trust you, to delight in you, and to praise you. Thank you, God. Thank you for the blessings past. Thank you for the blessings we are experiencing right now. And thank you for the blessings to come in 2021. Amen. Now, we will receive a selection from our music ministry.
Create me to worry. No, you didn't. trust in you.
Amen. We certainly want to thank Becky for blessing us in the ministry of music, that timely song, and also Reverend Rodney Francis for a powerful and timely sermon. Blessings to come in 2021, and what I like so much about it is telling us and challenging us and reminding us that we have a role in the blessings that we've received, because we're called to be a blessing, but just so powerful. I thank God for that message. And I particularly thank God for his insight that really this is the first Sunday of a new year. A new day has dawned upon us. And so may we walk in faith and gratitude this year. Rodney, thank you for blessing us this morning. Now you have an opportunity to participate in the service through your giving. For certainly the scripture says that God loves a cheerful giver. And one thing I know during my tenure here, and it's worth noting, this January I thought about it, that I have been here in the pulpit for 4 years. I started here on my journey here in January of 2017. And this has been a great journey because of your faithfulness and your stewardship and your service and your love. But I want to say that I want you to know I loved you before you loved me. So I want to make sure, if I haven't told you, that I love you, and my family and I, that we do love you and we thank God for you. But now you have an opportunity to give. And here at Covenant, we are excited about our giving. And those who may be watching us for the first time, you also have an opportunity to sow a seed into this ministry that we can continue to bless others in our neighborhood and our community through the word and through gifts and service in kind. And so we invite you to give. You can mail your offering to our address, or you can drop by the church and drop the offering in our tithing box in the back of the fellowship hall, or you can use our secured tithing app for your offering. With your offering in hand, your check all ready to go, your money there, let us pray a blessing over this offering. Dear God of deliverance, we pause during this time of worship to return to you some of the monetary riches that you have given us. While we wait in pensive silence, we are reminded to set our hearts and minds on your steadfast love. You alone are our rock, our fortress, and our salvation. We experience comforting solace in your refuge. Thanks be to God. And the people of God said, amen. Now, before we end our service this morning, just two announcements to bring to your attention. Millennial Ministry today, the millennials will be meeting today at noon here at the church. Bring your own lunch. We will be socially distancing and watching a movie and doing some other fun things. So please come out. If you're a millennial, we invite you to share with us today. Also, please note that there will be our annual congregational meeting will be next Sunday, January 31st at 2 p.m. via Zoom. We hope that you will join us on Zoom. We will send information of how to connect via Zoom in our Friday e-newsletter. But this will be an opportunity for us to see each other and to discuss the accomplishments, the challenges, and the financial status of the church, and we invite you and to be on the Zoom call on next Sunday, January 31st. And now, the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the people of God said, Amen.